Welcome to yet another OpenToonz tutorial. This is continuation from last week's tutorial on coloring and the style editor. I would recommend seeing that one first and then moving on to this one. You can see the link to that one on the screen right now. Just click on that. And today we are gonna talk about two different things. First, we talk about erasing color, and after that, we animate styles using the style editor and the level palette. So, as for erasing color, first, I will show you what you shouldn't do, and then I will show you what to do instead. Okay, so first, we're gonna delete styles. To delete a style, right-click on the style and choose Delete. You have two options, and I'm gonna go over both of them right now. If you only delete the style, it's replaced with red, and you can undo that. But if you delete the style, the lines, and the areas, that completely erases the style, and you cannot undo that at all. Also, if you delete a style, you cannot refill the area again. So, all in all, this is not a very good way to erase color, and I'm just showing this as a sort of cautionary tale. So, if you want to make a color transparent, select the style and go to the style editor, and use the slider to make the M value 0. This way the color does still exist, but you can also easily go back and change it. But if you want a color gone completely, you actually can use the eraser tool. I've seen some people not being able to erase areas, and that's because the default mode of the eraser tool only erases lines. But if you only want to erase color, change the mode to areas. Like that, you only erase color, but leave the lines untouched. Also, if you want to erase everything, change the mode to lines and areas, and that erases both. Okay, so now we will be animating colors fading between keyframes using the level palette and the style editor. We'll make two different kinds of fades, one a simple one from color to transparent, and a second one with more keyframes and colors. So let's begin. Here I have filled in an area on a new level with extended exposure. Also, make sure that you have the level palette to set the keyframes, the X sheet for timing them, and the style editor for editing the colors. So, to set the first keyframe, select a frame on the X sheet and click the key icon in the level palette. And the second one can be set in the same way. And you can see that when you set a keyframe, the key icon is highlighted blue. And that's how you can tell if there's a keyframe on a frame or not. Now we start changing the colors. So go to the style editor and use the slider to change it to whatever you want and click apply. And now we have to go to the first keyframe and change it there as well. And now if you play the animation, the color change is actually generated automatically. And now we're going to do a more complex fade. So set the new keyframe in the middle and change the color however you want and click apply. And since we already have the two other keyframes, we only need to edit the colors. Start with either one, just change the color and click apply. And the other one, again, just change the color and click apply. And now if we go through the frames, you can see how the colors change. So it all happens in one style. It might be confusing at first, but it's really organized. And I think in bigger scenes with a lot of colors, it's going to be a lifesaver. Okay, so that's that tutorial. So first of all, thank you so much for all the feedback and comments I've gotten so far. They really do help me, and please do keep posting them. And as usual, if you like this video, consider sharing it with your friends. And if you want to see more tutorials like this one, all you have to do is click subscribe. This one was posted on Tuesday, but I post tutorials every other Friday. So the next one will be posted on May 13th, and it will cover saving and managing projects. In the tutorial after that, I will talk about different kinds of animation in OpenToonz, and that will be a segue to more in-depth tutorials about animating in OpenToonz. So look out for those if you're interested. Also, in addition to tutorials, I post animation if you want to check my animations out. And I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I'll see you next time.